Some foreign power, some group of terrorists. Some individual concern.
Fighting an enemy. Fighting an enemy.
The rain that controls the past controls the living present. And therefore the future.
The future of the group is in doubt.
And that's my enemy, Jack.
The future of the group is in doubt.
New York, Bronx. ここはヒップホップカルチャー発祥の地。公民権運動直後の70年代初頭、グラフィティ、ラップ、そして B-Boys と呼ばれるストリートダンサーたちがギャングたちの縄張り争いと時を同じくして現れた。ドラッグ、貧困、暴力で荒れたゲットーの子供たちにヒップホップは別の価値観とライフスタイルを提供したのだ。ブロンクスリバーハウジングプロジェクト、ギャングの暴力がピークに達した60年代後半にはリトルベトナムとして悪名高かったこのアパートメント群も今では子供たちの歓声がこだまする平穏な住宅地となった。ここブロンクスリバーは地元で影響力を誇るローカルヒーローであり、 DJ、ラッパーとして活躍し、さらにズールーネーションという組織の創始者でもあるアフリカバンバータのホームグラウンドである。19世紀に出題したアフリカズール族の酋長の名を名乗るアフリカバンバータはヒップホップを世界に知らしめたヒップホップ文化の生みの親でもある。彼の夢は人々の平和と協調のための音楽帝国を築くことだった。
What was it like growing up in this area before you created Zulu Nation?
It was great. It was a great area, you know. There was a lot of power going on here, a lot of problems that was happening in the 60s with drugs, but we overcame that. Then there was a lot of gang violence that was happening in this area of the Southeast Bronx, and we overcame that. And then once the Zulu Nation became part of the life of many of the young adults and youth here, you just, you know, stretch from here, you know, to other parts of the Bronx, then other parts of Manhattan, and from New York City to other parts in America. So this was like a base, you know, the Mecca of the Zulu Nation, also the Mecca of hip-hop, you know, because a lot of people used to come here to party at the Bronx Service Center.
What's this phony ceremony hanging around? We got to get down, rock it out from this shaky ground. Come on and spread out your heart and body, mood everywhere. Let's see you people laughing, people punching out in the air. Get down to the hip-hop, a bebop, a new one. I wanna get ya, I wanna teach ya, I'm gonna get this beat to hit ya. Get down to big time, I lose your life on the rest. Come on and jump and jump and jump and jump.
Differences between cultures, it's very clear that African diasporatic cultures privilege certain kinds of rhythm. Not the, I mean, I'm talking about certain kinds of articulation, the use of meter, right? The use of certain kinds of timing are so heavily privileged. in West Indian culture, in Afro-American culture, in Afro-Brazilian, Afro-Cuban, Afro-Latin American. I mean, you can go all around the New World and find the same incredible privilege towards certain kinds of rhythmic articulation and voicing. So people who've done research on black music in the Americas are finding these kinds of things that are there. And I think what that means is that you learn those things culturally. They're not genetic necessarily. I'm not making that argument. What I am saying is that when you grow up in certain environments, and that's why I think third base works, okay, and why I don't think Marky Mark works, is that you become culturally attuned to certain kinds of ways of behaving, speaking, gesticulating. What I'm really getting at is that an absence of a kind of complex rhythmic pleasure spot is what makes him weak in that spot, and that becomes coded with being white. Okay, in other words, Western music, Western classical music is obsessed with melodic, almost scientific harmonic complexity, but the rhythm, the meter stays the same, so that it can allow you to do these other melodic things that are scientifically, tonally, and harmonically, okay, important. But rap music is not about harmony.
Nigga like me, cause I don't even, I don't sleep. Say that motherfucker's black as fuck as cheap. Let's take it to the streets and I'ma bring it to your ass, G. I'm coming from the heart, son, and I don't take no shit. But I'ma pop a start, so now which one of you hoes wanna show? If you got static, then get it off your chest, punk. The same boy, none. Ran
through the line like that, don't pop the piss in. I'm a stick. Now who do you love to hate? Cause I talk shit and down the eight ball, cause I don't break. You're begging, I'm so long. You grow up there, might as well put them doors on. Just call it trash, the bitches look black holes. I see a lot of others, man. It almost looks like the bad thing.
Bastards are acting out steel. About a minute to the electric studio. I don't give a fuck about this and these fools. They all scared of the interview. And when I say what I've been training on that, and they ain't even seen it yet.
The hit, yo.
With Ice Cube been caught
paying a gang on child support.
Then I thought deep about giving up the money. What I need to do is put the bitch in the tummy. While I'm there, I really get faded.
Wow.
Murder one because it was premeditated. So what I'ma do? I don't have a clue.
It's like a troublesome time. That's why it makes me wonder. How long can I pay on time when I put niggas under? A whole family with prices on their head.
Got a little bite to that motherfucker. The other one is all right too. We just didn't curse at it.
Window up.
All right.
Yo, what's up? What's up? Man, yo, I see.
What's up, man?
ズールーネーション結成以前、アフリカバンバータは友人や支持者たちとブロンクスリバーハウジングプロジェクトでパーティーを開いていた。同時にブロンクスの他の地域でもライバルグループによってパーティーが開かれた。ジャマイカ出身で強力なサウンドシステムが評判のクール DJ ハークは西ブロンクスで、ターンテーブルアクロバットの先駆者グランドマスターフラッシュは南ブロンクスで、グランドマスターフラッシュのラッパーメリーメルが当時の頃を振り返ってくれた。
they used to be like black spades. They used to be black spades around here. So when Bam made the Zulu Nation, that automatically transformed. But, you know, some of the guys still had their old ways. You know, they wasn't gangbanging no more. They was into music, but, you know, some of the guys still had their ways. So when you came around there, you definitely, you know, had to know a few people, you know, and you just had to, you know, just watch your back. First time I came here, one time Bam and them was out here, and we came by, you know, just to see the block party, but we caught the tail end, and they was wrapping things up. And so Biggs was on the mic cursing and yelling, and then he said, then Biggs said, and then we gonna go up to Parkchester and fuck up some white people. If y'all down, say yeah. It's like, yo, let's get out of here, man. Let's get out of here. Go crazy. And one time me and Scorp and all of us came here, they had a little party there, and that was the first time we got shot at. You know, right, somebody okay. Just shooting at
they
us.
Just didn't want us here.
Yeah, so we got up, you know, let's walk
flash
cool.
Crew. All right.
Let's walk real cool.
Word up.
We got around this corner here. We didn't stop running till we got over the bridge over there.
No question.
Get up out of here.
Probably was Mickey in him.
Yeah, Mickey.
Word up.
Put the camera on him.
Camera on him.
Like me, Jay.
The guy shooting.
Oh, man.
The man with the gun.
He was shooting.
Y'all the businessman now. Don't do that.
He was the one. He got us
up out down
here.
Before we put out the message. They trying to get us.
I moved in Bronx River in 1970. And Bam was already living here. You know, we just grew up from kids together. We all hung out, you know, started up our little gangs and running around, terrorizing things. And then, you know, as you get older, you get smarter. Stop doing dumb things.
Dumb shit.
Zulu Nation は最初 Zulu Kings という5人組のダンサーのバックとしてスタートした。Zulu Kings は巷で一番のダンサーとの評判で、誰もがメンバーに加わりたがっていた。初期の頃から参加したグループの一つ、ロックステディクルーはヒップホップ一つ、Zulu Nation のメンバーとして長く活動している。ステディクルーはグラフィティアーティスト、ラッパー、DJ からなるダンスグループ。ストリートでブレイクダンスをし、街中の壁にグラフィティアーツ、つまり落書きを施すなど、いわゆる B-Boys と呼ばれた彼らは当時世間から眉をしかめられる存在でもあった。
You know what's the problem I had with the media? They didn't get into the technical aspect and understand that there was a true foundation to what was created and thatIn order to be a b-boy, you really had to have style. A b-boy isn't a person that could just spin on his head or spin on his back. It's a whole style. It's a whole understanding of the culture that you really feel. And someone can actually, like, say, damn, that's a powerful move. Instead of somebody just spinning, it's like his whole personality is into it. It's not for the sake of doing something, making money and doing a commercial. It's for the sake of, yo, even if you weren't doing that commercial,you're still gonna dance and be as creative because you're living hip-hop. Did you hear that gunshot back there? Oh, man.
It was a gun.
Yeah, it was a gun.
Hey, when you leave.
is not rap. Hip-hop is not b-boying. Hip-hop isn't graffiti. You know, you need, each one needs each other in order to be considered. You can't just sit, be out there and be a rapper and have a sell a million records or whatever and say you're a hip hopper, because all you did was do a rap record. Some people don't even have an understanding of the fact that Afrika Bambaataa, myself, Melly Mel, Mr. Big, Soul Sonic Force, all the graffiti writers, Shy 147, Zephyr, Futura, Devious Dolls, that we all presented hip hop as a culture. We brought it on tour and showed them exactly what we were doing in the streets at our jams, whether it was just showing our black books with graffiti on it or just dancing in a circle when the music came on while the rappers were rapping and DJs were DJing. Okay, you need the whole thing.
Sisters to find jobs and to organize and stop, you know, a lot of violence in the street, to use their time and effort to do something for themselves and to do for their people. The Zulu Nation started off as a black and Hispanic organization. And then eventually when we started going downtown into the rock clubs, a lot of young whites and punk rockers and new wavers started joining the organization. Then as we traveled throughout the world, bringing the hip-hop culture, a lot of people from different countries, from France, England, Japan, Africa, you know, Latin America, started joining Zulu Nation through all the groups that was part of the Zulu Nation in hip-hop.
Hip-hop は徐々にローアーマンハッタンに浸透し、子供たちはストリートで踊り稼ぐようになり、プロモーターは彼らをクラブへ出演させるようになった。それまで地元での演奏のみに満足していたバンバータ初のダウンタウン公演は、マルコム・マクラレンがバウアウアウのリッツ公演の前座に彼とロックステディクルーを起用した時だった。ローアーマンハッタンにあるロキシーで毎週趣向を凝らしたヒップホップショーを仕組み、またヒップホップアーティストを初めてヨーロッパへ連れて行くなど、このサブカルチャーに魅せられた一人のイギリス人女性プロモーターがいた。
Rappers, graffiti artists, and DJs. I mean, there was like 19, 20 people on that tour. DST was on the tour, Bambaataa, Jazzy J, the Rocksteady Crew, Fat Five Freddy, Ramelzy, a lot of people. It was like, you know, first time out of the country, so for them it was like seeing different cultures and how other people live, and just being also really inspired that other people could get into what they were doing, which they just thought was something they, which was so natural for them to do in America as a form of fun for them, to actually see people, you know, in other countries actually getting into it and being able to relate to it was really like amazing, I think, to them. And they realized that they could take it further, you know, it wasn't just something they could just do weekend at their mate's house or on a street corner with a bunch of break dancers.
3000人収容を誇るオートバンボールルームもヒップホップショーの重要な公演場所の一つだった。
This is like one of the first spots, this spot, one of the first spots in Manhattan where there were a lot of hip hop shows in the early days, and all these guys used to play here, Bam and Hollywood and Flash, you know. So I mean, not only was this like Malcolm X was assassinated, but it was also like one of the birthplaces of hip hop. At the time, you couldn't buy records. You might have been able to buy tapes off the streets, and people were selling them. But at the time, if you wanted to hear rap music, you couldn't go to Madison Square Garden or go to some big arena. You had to come to places like this. You know.
60年代の人権活動家マルコム X と、その死でイスラム国家を築いたエリア・モハメッドに影響を受けたイスラム教徒のバンバータは、アフリカ民族主義の色濃い組織ズールーネーションを作った。 古代アフリカ史やアフリカ系アメリカ人の歴史を勉強し、アフリカの民族衣装やアクセサリーを身につけることを奨励することにより、若い黒人のプライドと自尊心を復活させようとしたのだ。アイスキューブ、KRS-1 やパブリックエナミーによる特に政治的、性的に赤裸々なラップはメディア、音楽業界、そして警察などの社会規制の手によって細かくチェックされている。それは明らかにラップの歌詞の持ち得る危険性とその音楽形態がストリートバイオレンスに結びつく直接の要因と見られているからである。
This is for the rap concert. With this level of security usual?
Yeah, usual. All kinds.
Yeah? Not just because of being rap or label?
この夜もパブリックエナミーのコンサートに多数の警官が動員されていた。
That's the fear of the real Black Planet, I think Chuck D should be referring to. It's the aesthetics that they're afraid of. I mean, no one's really afraid Black is going to run America tomorrow. Nobody who's not paranoid and crazy thinks that we're going to wake up and be running the country. Either that or in a massive dream state, you know. But I mean, what they're really afraid of is the kind of the fact that white kids are obsessed and get so much pleasure from Black aesthetics. And they have since rock and roll and before, jazz, all the same. And they're terrified of that because then you begin to have an affinity. You can't other somebody that easily if you love their background. You can't turn them into evil outsiders if you're dying to go where they are.
Hallelujah.
All right.
Let's say it.
Yeah, say it before I drop. Yeah,
say it before I drop.
They got about 100.
Well, definitely, rap definitely opened up the minds of a lot of people, you know what I'm saying, through the individuals like Public Enemy. Like, a lot of kids wouldn't know what's going on if they wasn't listening to, like, a Public Enemy tape or something, you know, or like, what's his name, Ice Cube or somebody, you know. See, they don't... The media don't like these, you know, they don't like us listening to this type of stuff because they know our youth is like listening to this stuff and saying, oh, so that's what really goes on. You know what I'm saying? If they got us just listening to all these bullshit R&B radio stations that ain't playing shit, you know, all our kids do is grow up in the park dancing.
Yeah.
And they don't know what's going on. All they do is think life is a whole big party. But when somebody start dropping lyrics like, all right, they trying to kill us this way and they trying to do this, then the young minds is like, oh shit, I gotta start protecting myself. Is this the plot? You know what I'm saying? If this is the plot, then I gotta kind of, you know, counteract that. I gotta do something. You gotta open up their minds, and that's, you know, that's what these type of artists are doing. They opening up the minds of the youth.
I see it like far as the rap is concerned, like the records. I don't believe that they give the full picture to the incidents, but what they do is they whet the appetite of the youth. And once you whet the appetite of intellect, then the intellect wants to know more about a certain situation. So what rap does is just whet that appetite, you know, to want to know, you know what I'm saying? You want to know about exactly what is Public Enemy talking about? What is the political stance that they're taking?
文化としてのヒップホップが西海岸へたどり着くのには時間がかかった。西海岸には常にポッピングやロッキングといった特有のダンススタイルがあったため、ラップやグラフィティアートはニューヨークを離れ、西へ渡ったアーティストたちの口コミによって広まった。
I started off just bobbing.
Bobbing being what's it?
Bobbing in terms of doing illegals, just hitting handball courts. We hit different city halls in the smaller cities, Bell Gardens, Paramount, Compton, Southgate, Linwood, Huntington Park, HP, Vernon, and just going out at night just doing illegals, man.
Did you ever get caught?
I've gone to county. Yeah, I got caught a couple times, man.
How did they deal with you?
Basically, they. The last time I got caught, which was the first time, they took me to county, just county, they hooked you up with a couple months. It's about it.
You had to stay in jail for 2 months.
2 months, yeah.
For graffiti.
Yeah, yeah.
And King, do malagasta, let me do my thing. For those that don't know what I'm talking about, do malagasta means rock the house. But the baddest, baddest, they can't manage. The brother that's tannish, doing damage. English, Spanish, Spanish, and Inglés. No matter how I say it, it still come out fresh. Never fading, fretting, or making a deal. Latin King, bring the style that's real. Twin hips on the mic is the ideal meal. And play cut the record just like a cuchillo. That's a knife, do it easy. I low fussy, running gun with the Puerto Rock posse. Move, quit picking the groove. Now let me tell you what I'm trying to prove. Watch me before us, to wear frowns, Hispanic, black, we all being held down. No matter what color, color, race, or rasta. Yo, homeboy, tumba la casa.
To me, Chief, basically hip-hop is just a coalition of rap music. Not the trendy bullshit, man. Tone Loke, all these idiots, man. L.A. Dream, all that fake stuff, man. There's different angles on the rap itself. The breakdancer, man, and the graffiti. And to me, it's a whole subculture. It's not something that you could basically give to everybody. You know what I'm saying? You gotta work to pay your dues to be in it. That's what it comes down to for me.
Pay your dues, what do you mean, man?
Pay your dues. If you're a graffiti artist, go out and bomb. Don't just do stuff. You know, this is legal. This is a legal piece. I've been getting away with bombing in an area that it didn't look like nobody could get away with doing it. And I've just built up. As a graffiti artist, put your time to doing trains, RTD systems. Put your time to bombing, hitting freeways, doing all kinds of things, man. As a breakdancer, put your time, not just biting things, but making up your own moves. Making up your own techniques, routines, and just stay busy, stay real with it, man. You know what I'm saying? If everybody's wearing a Le Tigre, don't just go out and get Le Tigre. You know what I'm saying, man? In other words, stay innovative and stay original, man. That's what I try to do with my graffiti.
As life goes on, you want to know more. And since we're expressing ourselves as far as through the lyrics and through the dance, we express a lot of anger, so it gives us the drive also to find out why we're angry as we mature. So we start to learn and say, wait a second, oh, this is fucked up, man. Columbus wasn't the first person to set foot on America. It was probably the slave that docked the boat for him.
Yeah.
You know?
Another thing is like hip hop ain't a way of life that people translate it. It's our tools of expression. Our way of life has always been peace with the Zulu Nation and all that. Hip hop is the tools, the way we get the message across to people. It's not, it's really supposed to be presenting positivity. If you notice, all the rappers now are getting into the negative gangster image. You know, we've been through all that in the past. Now we can use hip hop as a way to get a positive message across to kids.
The Zulu Nation was a central force in hip-hop. Afrika Bambaataa started it as a way, I think, to redirect certain kinds of energies. I mean, I think he saw a population of frustrated but unrealized frustration. Zulu Nation and Bambaataa became a place for that, a cultural place for that, a place to look at the past, to maybe think about the present. And I think it was a central thing in hip-hop, but I also think hip-hop was fundamentally about play. It was about having a good time. I mean, we can't underestimate the significance of fun. The only reason Public Enemy works is because you can have a good time. The worst rap in the world is political diatribe without either a slamming backbeat, you know, a funky riff, or a Flavor Flav vibe. It doesn't work.
Probably had a big beef. Because of that, now I get my teeth. So here's a song to the song about the shake of the state. And a smile went along with that.
Can't trust it. So watch your step, boy. Can't trust it. Watch your step, boy. Can't trust it. On a step, boy. Can't trust it. We're playing, boy. Can't trust it. That's right, boy. We men. Can't trust it. We men. You can feel it. Can't trust it.
Get justice!
rat.
What's this about?
The whole piece says rat trap.
What does it mean?
It's talking about anything, man, in the streets. You could either add to them and get busy and move ahead and keep enhanced and try to touch others, try to unify and get things going, or you can lose yourselves, man, to prostitution, to bam, slinging that rock, or homosexual, or any type of stuff, man. And that's what the rat is for, man. If you take a bite, man, you're going to get caught by the trap, man.
When you talk about mass gathering of the black youth, and also the white youth, and they come together when they usually don't come together, you're going to have something spill over the sides. Because usually nobody gives a damn about the kids anyway. Yo, I get a whole cooked meal tonight, man. Yo, man, you don't know.
What?
Man, let me tell you now.
Here come the drums.
All right. Yeah. All right.
Here come the drums.
As I became older and more into the vibe, I recognized this world networking potential. Africa Barabada and a lot of the artists, Africa Islam, a lot of the artists from the 80s traveled to many places when they took that vibe with them. And that vibe was still kept in those areas and thrust upon and planted and fermented and grown. And it, you know, respective areas. So each one of the places that we visited had that Zulu Nation vibe that we can very much just link ourselves into, and those that come even after us, you know. It's just a vibe of brotherhood, you know. It doesn't really separate color, you know, or anything. It just, what it is, it's one belief that everybody is just on an equal plane and should be right to each other.
彼らズールネーションのメンバーの来日には自らのコンサートの他に日本のヒップホップアーティストを発掘しプロデュースするという目的もある。
Mel, how is it to be from the old school and still like rap now that everything has changed and what's the record?
Well, it's hard because people think you're an old man. You see, because being that I started out so young, right, there's like a lot of guys like Hammer, he's older than me, Flavor, Chuck D, all these guys is older than me, right? But people see me as an old man because I started when I was young. So it's like you always gotta you gotta prove yourself like twice again, because they figure that you just ain't got it no more.
彼らは最初にここで言ってたみたいに、自分たちの
住んでるブロックで の, そのカルチャーみたいなものでスタートして、それで自分たち の, あの不安あのいろんな不満なこととかあの自然発生的に出てきたわけだから、それをだから日本人がやろうとしたら僕無理だと思うし、日本人は日本の不安を不満っていうものをラップで表せないと思うね。ラップじゃないもので表した方が僕はいいと思う。というのはどうしても借りたものを使ってやってるっていう、そううさんくささがね、結構そういうふうな本物に聞こえないの。だからカンアーティストみたいに聞こえちゃう。ずっしりとした重みが全然ない。
アフリカ一覧。80年代世界のトップ DJ として活躍。現在アフリカバンバータに代わってズールーネーションのリーダーとしてその重責を果たしている。
The drum I get wicked, 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 get. I get wicked, wicked, I get wicked, I get wicked, wicked, I get wicked, get wicked, get wicked, get wicked. The drum I get wicked.
It was a competitive source that you could parallel it to, tribes in Africa that chanted and fought against each other in the sense of cultural rhythms of Rastafarians in Jamaica, which did the same chanting. It was very close to it. That's where it derived its roots from. And it wasn't a primitive form until 1976, and our means, instead of making bands, our means of a band was a DJ and a mic, a DJ and a rapper.
The records you play and where you say
looks like one great big alleyway.
And you require all the numbers to book,
take the stuff, baby, and pushes in the big money makers.
Drop the big cars, pay the 20s and 10s.
And you wanna grow up to be just like them.
We owe it to the forefathers who started it. Whether it was an Indian chief beating the drum or whether it was an African chief beating the drum, it was a means of communication. And now it's a means of communication. It's a subculture. And now the subculture is not basically black and Hispanic. The subculture is, as you can tell, we're in Japan.
Right.
And the subculture is unique because it's a youth movement that's developed itself and overcome such means as it didn't take a lot of money to do it. People didn't do it for the money. They did it because they loved the love of art. So it was natural. It came from the heart. And it was a way of self-expression, a way of status, a way of showing abilities, and a way of strengthening one's own self-esteem, mind, body, and soul, and spirit.
It began in Africa. Thousands of years before the coming of the black prophet Jesus. As a matter of fact, archaeologists now admit Africa is where it all began, evidently. It began with an inventive black man, perhaps astounded at the beauty of the universe around him.
What does it all mean?
Been a long time. I said the
dwell in what I do well. And my first passion is communicating with the people, and because the people is me, you know, and I like information, I like truth, I like facts, because I'd like to translate that in a language where my children understand and grow up and understand that you're not inferior, you're equal. You're not superior, you're equal.
Into the rhyme, it's on.
Yeah.
But remembering the rhyme, the entire rhyme, the full segment of the rhyme, sometimes it's hard to find it. And then it just pops up.
So what you do when you forget it, like you kind of improvise a little bit of it?
But you gotta do it right, because if you fuck up, you'll look real stupid.
Yeah.
You know, some people fuck up and you can cover it up sometimes, you know.
You look like this.
Drunk out.
Yo, Mel, wait, what you doing?
My drunken style is quite effective. Give me that microphone. Sit down, cause a brother like me is known to get out of that chip. That's a favorite line of mine.
Rap is taken from bebop and skit scat. If you look back into history, that's where it originated from. The beatbox is nothing, you know, it's the same with, Bobby McFerrin does, but you know, Dougie Fresh and Biz Markie with two rhythmic passes as well. But I believe that was inherited through the onslaught of slavery on with the soulful and the blues which emanated, and then you had a style of rap which, you know, directly came from the 1960s of the Black Panther movements and, this, you know, the civil rights movements where chants were pronounced, you know, free at last, and, you know, give peace a chance, where the chants, at the same time you're dealing with people like Gil Scott Heron and the Last Poets, which originated the poetry style over music, you know, which evolved into the rap style that it is of today.
When you first start to make a rap, what is it, like some news you hear or something you see or some experience you have?
Nope. I'm not trying to, like, a lot of people use things to get over. Some people go on this political thing, other people's on, they're on some old hype. I rap, let's see, what can I say about that? It's what I feel. Mm. What I feel, what I do. I see a fine girl with a big ass and some nice tits. I'll write me a fly joint about a big ass and some nice tits. No, let me stop. But not really. But that's pretty much how it is. That's really how it is. Yo, man, wake up, man. I can't sleep. You can't sleep.
Somebody say go, Mally, go, Mally, go.
A lot of a rapper's downfall is the fact that they don't work their craft toward like the full aspect of what rap is, but then that's only because they don't know the full circle of rap, like starting from the pen and the pad stage to the crowd stage to the record stage, mm-hmm. and then maybe even to the video stage. A good 85% of all the rappers, if you was to tell them, well, say a rhyme that's other than the record, the records that you produce or a record that you're going to put out, they couldn't rhyme for you. They just couldn't just say straight rhymes. They could only write records and your craft is always going to get sharpest when you're writing the rhyme.
You got your songs that you got on your record. Now, to be able to say something else besides that shit, to be able to rap off the top of your head, you know what I'm saying? We're sitting on the floor at an interview. It's just four, and I'm in you. You got the camera in my face, and I'm blowing it off the top of my head, and I'm flowing with it. Here I am, I'm drinking sake, not a karate, not a disc jockey, but an MC Prince who rocks the microphone and whip a whip, living like a samurai. Leave me alone, you know? Just top of the head shit.
It could be done all day. Nah, these sharp. You know? And that's a perfected craft. That's a craftsman.
You look at hip hop culture now, and it's like a hip hop equivalent. You know, I mean, you look at a movie like Boys in the Hood, and you see, even though it was a movie about rap music, you know that John Singleton grew up with hip hop because it has like, to it, you know what I'm saying? I can't wait to see the canvas of the person who's inspired by Chuck D. You know what I'm saying?
Put it this way, if it wasn't for hip-hop, I'd be gone, you know what I'm saying? If it wasn't for having an outlet to go against the system, for me to go express myself on trains, on anything that I could, man, I'd be a product, I'd be gone, and it's more of the same problems, you know what I'm saying? In New York and in L.A., a city's a city.
After marriage, the honeymoon, I'll be dead to eat with a soul. Do love, pop, pop, Alice and Doom. Ladies, let your body go. Run to jail, let a guy like an Eskimo. And the next day, drive up a monkey show. Gonna get me in a cannibal, a Eskimo. Play nice, my mind's like a fairy tale. Yo, hawk up, and a big, big day. Yo, know the fat girl who broke the scale. Yo, two more tail, yo. I won't stay, yo, with God and tell I'm gonna say stay, yo.
By the same stylist, in the same group.
Terminator X, the DJ, and
call him just plain.